Hi, I'm Natalie Mendoza, and I'm playing Gigi.
And I'm Chris Peluso, and I am playing Chris. Definitely. Before every show on the West End, there's a physical and vocal warm-up that the entire company takes in. And that's not the same in the U.S. Broadway shows, and I particularly love that.
Yeah, our group warm-up is really fantastic, actually. It's a new experience for me, too, and it's just a... I don't know why people don't do it everywhere, actually, because it really unites the company, and so you're already... There's this united feeling before we even set foot on stage. It's quite, it's a really interesting psychological shift. I've noticed a big difference. I like it. I'm really lucky, actually, because the song I get to sing, which is Movie in My Mind, is at the moment where, because the moment that the show opens in a really energetic, sort of in your face, it's very visceral, really exciting, powerful. And then in an instant, we drop into the brokenness of the entire play. And that moment is actually my song, which is Movie in My Mind. And I think it sets up the emotional core of the entire piece, because I think all characters have a brokenness that they have to deal with. And so that's one of my favorite moments. And it's also one of my favorite moments because it's quite unique in theater where you see women come together. And that's the moment I was really touched by. It's why I wanted to be in this production, because it was so, it was almost like if it was a film, it would be a close-up moment of all these women. And you get to see behind their masks and the real suffering that they're going through and the actual strength that they share as a unit. And it's quite powerful to see a group of women come together in that way. It's incredibly moving, it's why I wanted to be in this show.
The best role I ever played is probably Chris in the Saigon, the West End, to be honest. I also love playing Tony in West Side Story, aside from Chris.
I recently played Imelda Marcos in Eli's Love at the National Theatre, and that was a pretty phenomenal role to be able to play, just because of I got to basically play her from a very young girl right through to the age she currently is. So that's a real gift for an actor. I actually think Gigi is one of my favorite roles as well. The way this production's fleshed that character out and really given her a lot of levels that weren't as clearly defined originally. So that's a point of difference with this show. And I love actually the simplicity of telling quite a clear story, which I'm able to do with Gigi. I think with Imelda, there was so much going on that that provided a very unique challenge, but this is quite a lovely show to do because it's incredibly emotional and challenging to be able to switch gears and drop into that emotion very quickly. It's a real discipline, and I'm enjoying that experience. I walk through Regent's Park, which is really quite a mystical place, I think. It's just something quite beautiful about just, being at one with nature. Because our lives are quite noisy, I think, and being in London is quite noisy. So to actually find a place where you're just completely zoned out, it's really wonderful. That's one of my favorite things. And also visiting all the galleries and all the culture here is just astonishing. There's an endless list of things I have to do.
I also have a dog, and he's my baby. And so I take him to the parks, Hyde Park, Regent's Park. But other than walking my dog, I would have to say the restaurants. And I'm I'm somewhat surprised as an American, we give London a bad rap for food. We give the UK a bad rap for food. Everyone's like, oh, it's great there, but the food. The food is excellent. So listen, anyone from America, it's really good here. So I love the restaurants.
It's funny, I come from a family of artists, and my godfather was actually quite a famous clothing designer. He's just designed for Princess Diana, and he also was a set designer and costume designer. So I kind of grew up in his workshop. So that, we all have this weird sensibility for fashion in our family, but it's not necessarily about following trends. It's really coming more from an artistic perspective. And my father's a jazz musician, and a jazz arranger, and he worked with some of the great jazz musicians of our time. So, it was quite often I'd walk home and there'd be a jazz band rehearsing in our living room. And my mother was a dancer and also in theatre, and she was also a TV personality in Australia. So just to set the scene. So we all kind of have found areas that we're more passionate about. I have six siblings and they're all artists. And one's a photographer and a director. And I also am a film director. I'm moving into that area. I also write. And it's just, I just see myself as an artist, actually. I don't see myself as any one particular thing. I'm writing at the moment, and I'm also producing a new show. And Alex Dingus is going to be involved with that and producing. So putting on the producer hat's a little more foreign to me because I'm not driven by the sort of business side of things, but there's also creativity in that, so I'm enjoying it. But wherever my heart takes me and whatever I feel passionate about. One thing my father always says, don't be a jack of all trades, and I've always been fearful that that's what I've become. But I suppose I actually just try to approach everything with real passion. And and if you do that, I think you can do everything quite well.
Because of the incredible story, that would be my first instinctual response. It's a beautiful story of a young girl dealing with quite a bit of hardship, and dealing with it in such a profound, mature way. And in addition to the story, you also have incredible music. I love singing this score, and I love hearing this score. So, story, music.
Can't go wrong. Lawrence hasn't sort of held back in the presentation of scenes and the tone of the piece. It feels really visceral, really in your face, and it tears your heart out. It's just, it's beautiful. And then it's this incredible love story as well, so I think it's one of the best shows out there right now.